Want to know more about different careers? CareerTrack is traveling across beautiful British Columbia to show a day in the life of various professions. Heavy equipment operators, social workers, VR designers, and mechanics. After all, it's one thing to read about a job, but it's another to see it in action. So join us as we explore some of BC's in-demand jobs. You might be surprised by what you find.
Are you fascinated by the hidden systems beneath our feet? Our next guest specializes in managing and protecting one of our most vital resources, groundwater. Let's meet a hydrogeology engineer. Emily, it's lovely to meet you.
Hi, Mary, it's nice to meet you. We've got some cool stuff to show you today.
Let's do it.
I'm Emily, I'm a hydrogeological engineer. Been working in the industry for 6 years. Grew up in Alberta, moved out here to BC 10 years ago. Now I guess you could say I'm Vancouver local. I work in groundwater projects or in the environmental field, trying to prevent water contamination. We basically study groundwater problems and design solutions. Early in a project, it's a lot about data collection, so we might be planning drilling programs. I might go out to the field and collect data, logging soils, installing instruments.
Emily, this looks complicated and impressive. I'm so tempted to press all the buttons. What are we looking at?
So I'm getting ready to go to a mine site. We're going to inspect some wells. They might have some damage, so we're going to put this camera down the hole and see what's going on. Do you want to flip the on switch?
Definitely. This one right here?
That's the one.
Ooh, there it goes. Right.
Do you want to start lowering it down? Just
this
turn
thing?
That wheel, yep.
Okay.
And feed the cable over the wheel.
Oh, there it goes. Emily, this was so cool. Good luck using it in the field next week.
Thanks. I actually had a hard time deciding what I wanted to do in high school. I had different interests. I was interested in social issues, environmental issues, but I got interested in groundwater problems because it's an intersection of environmental and social issues. There's no undergrad really in hydrogeological engineering. Your undergrad might be in geological engineering or sometimes civil engineering, maybe environmental engineering, and then the specialization comes either through work or it's also common to do a master's.
Emily, it is a gorgeous day in Vancouver today, but I can't imagine it's always like this when you're out in the field. How do you manage that?
Yeah, it's very true. I mean, next week it could be snowing, raining. I think it's just be prepared for different conditions. It's planning ahead and then it's having a backup plan ready to go.
Yeah, it sounds like you have to be really adaptable.
I think it's the key in this field. There's lots of unexpected surprises. It's part of what makes it fun. One of the most challenging things about this field is the level of uncertainty. It makes it very interesting. There's always lots of new problems, unexpected problems, and you're constantly adapting. But at the same time, I think it keeps it exciting.
Emily, what you do here is absolutely fascinating.
Thank you so much for coming. I'm always happy to talk about what I do.
Once again, I'm Miriam for CareerTrack, reminding you that this career could be yours.